little sparked up a little bit.
See what I'm saying?
Never escape.
All right, people. So today, we're going to be shooting a few different guns at the range here. The range in the woods we got. It's going to be a different type of video compared to other types of videos I've done in the past, where I'm going to be doing drills and courses on these videos, but it's going to be like a little more laid back type, but you're going to still get some action. We're going to get different types of guns out and shoot them and just have a, you know, I've done so many course videos here lately. I'm going to give that a little break and just implement the courses that I've showed you in the past into these just normal shooting videos, which are not exactly normal because they're courses and drills. But we're going to get the pair of ordnance out today, which is a beast. Okay, it's had around 1,200 to 1,300 rounds put through it. It's the GI Expert model. I've switched grips too, by the way, as you can tell. We're going to get that out. And on my back here, I got the good old Marlin Model 60. Alright, so we're going to get these out today. I'm going to shoot the Marlin Model 60 from 100, and we'll probably push about 110 yards with it, with Federal Gold Match ammunition. And the pair of ordnance, we're just going to do a drill with it right quick with some like good old Tula bimetal. So anyway, let's get started with it. Alright, people, so first, obviously, I'm here at the trash can. We're going to do a little course with a pair of ordnance right here, 1911. And I got four people right there, as you can see, four body targets. So I'm going to come up, of course, and we've done this drill before in the past. Y'all have seen it. We'll pop up and quick as I can, take all four of them out. It's one shot per target. Because if you see them twitching, you can always rack another one off. Alright. Talking about self-defense training here. And then with the good old Marlin Model 60 here, we're going to head up there at 110 yards. So, just to give you another little briefing. So, we'll get started here as soon as I get this next little. Take a look. Back out there. Oh shit, I hit the wrong. Dang, people. All right, let's see. First guy, looking pretty good, gut shot. Second guy, gut shot. That's great. Third guy, gut shot. Fourth guy, arm shot, but I could have easily laid another one on him. So no big deal. It's all about that speed, baby. Now let's move up there to 110 yards with the 22 Marlin Model 60. So for fun, at 110 yards with the Marlin Model 60, I'm going to be shooting at this Cyclops one eye here, big 2-inch, 2.5-inch eye. That's a little drippy there. Expert spray painted, boy. Which is about the size of a dip can. And so also for kicks, because I've kicked the dipping habit, I'm just going to try to set this somewhere. We'll pop it here too. I'll set it up. We'll pop it this motherfucker as well. All right, people, so we're up here at 110 yards and we're gonna be shooting at that dip can, you know, all the shit I showed you down there, okay, with some Federal Gold. Here, let me show you right quick. Bear with me. This Federal, the gold match shit, gold metal, my bad, I keep saying gold match, but you get the point. I'll lay it right there for your viewing pleasure.
Now, I ain't shot this 22 in probably a couple weeks. Every bit of it, 110 yards. Now, each ammo you got, you already know that. You got to aim up different. It's different velocities and shit. You know, so can't quite remember where to hold this one at, but, you know, we'll give it a try. I'm aiming at that Cyclops eyeball first, just to kind of get a reference on where to kind of shoot. Like I say, I'm just doing these different videos, trying to throw a little variety into it, you know what I'm saying? Kind of curious to see where I was hitting, shooting at that Cyclops eyeball once again. I'll go down there and have just a little small look, like I say. Oh, shit. Oh. Midget bench. Well, that ain't bad, folks. You can see where I hit right there. And I ain't shot in 3 weeks with this thing here. And last time I shot was a different ammunition. Let's go for the dip can this time.
All right,
I had 5 rounds in here, so means I got 3 left. Cause I'm a mathematician beast. I just come up with that. Cause I'm a fucking genius. All right, let's see if we can't hit that dip can. Let's go see where we hit it.
Well, I'll tell you what, kicking the damn habit one bullet at a time. Well, like I said, with a bullet, kicking the habit. Kicking its ass with a... See right there, it still had some in it. That proves I told you out there and wasn't dipping this shit no more. I told you. So, that still counted. I had it set up like this. It's a good hit still. 110 yards, which is, we're gonna shoot at it again. Who was that?
All right, let's give it another shot. See if we can't hit the grizzly can again. Some pine needles, you know, falls here. Everything's falling. That's why they call it fall. All right. Nah, I didn't see it move. I ain't saying I didn't hit it. But let's give it one more shot. That's strange. Let's give it another shot. We'll still be able to see where we hit down there. Are we out of rounds? Look at that. You know what that means?
All right, folks.
I mean, I know some of y'all might want to watch me load this gun. I don't know. I've had videos in the past where I was loading it, so if you want to go scavenge around, you can find some. Let's give it another try. I'll hold it different this time. That's gotta be, I mean, we gotta go in there and take a look at that. I'm not doing nothing any different.
Believe it or not, folks, you're going to shit. Now, you've seen the dip cam before. The back was not busted out. I put a hole right through that hole. And, I mean, literally, for all I know, I could have put all those shots in that same hole. And based off that little dent on the side right there, as you see, where I'm getting ready to point at. See that little dent? I think one nipped right there and the other one went in the hole. That's not bad. I've still been fucking something up. We're gonna go ahead and shoot a few more times.
Alright, people, I'm walking 110 yards back up here out of breath. Let's see if I can't do it. I
say that because, you know, if you're hunting or something shit like that, you're going to be not out of breath. You know what I mean? You got to sit around for hours. A lot of you know what I'm talking about. So I'm going to shoot this thing one more time down there, see where I hit. Then I'm going to let my son take a try or two. And we'll see how he fares up. And he's never even shot this gun except a few times before. Just a few times, you know what I'm saying? Not a whole lot. Not as much as he has at 702 points.
All right.
Yeah, I hit it. I'll go down there and prove it to you. How many rounds I got left in here? I ain't counting. I got a couple.
Folks, I ain't sure. But like I said, when I first put this down here, the thing was it was snapped, all right? There was no hole in the back. Like, gape cracked ass open like that. That's a hard call on that shot there, bro, folks. What's that tell you? I don't know if it went in there or not. I did see the thing freaking move. But let's see what old Drake can't do. Alright, people.
It fell.
Good. Go ahead and take that last shot on the sock box there. Cool. Well, he helped me finish kicking this habit here, folks. Look at that. Busted the fucking pieces. Nasty. Get you some mouth cancer. So he hit it, as you can tell. And Mr. Cyclops head, if you remember where all the placements were, he hit that as well too. So he done a good job, because he don't normally shoot that gun at all. He hasn't hardly shot much at all. He's more of a 702 plinkster, he's got that. He shot it a lot though. So he done a good job. Thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you on the next one. Mixing it up a little on this one. Thanks for watching.